O pilgrim of the path of art, a spring in your steps belaying your age, and your speech dripping with affection and the voice spanning the tilt of the full octave. In every bit of your being, there's a flow of rainbow hues, your eyes that brim with childlike astonishment, an emergence of creative meditation with the very first stroke on the canvas. As with colors and forms, there's a sweet rapport with the written word. Fragrance of joy pervades your heart, and that heart's always on the upsurge, wanders along the path of spiritual attainment, showering love while you celebrate all that you cherish. O pilgrim on the divine path of arts, who has as if lost his way in this materialistic world, may your creations and every breath of yours, your life, your world, reflect eternally the beauty of this Mother Earth.
The heights by great men reached and kept were not attained by sudden flight, but they, while their companions slept, were toiling upward in the night. He is only about 159 centimeters tall and probably never weighed more than 55 kilos. But Natu Parikh was a towering presence in the classroom. When I attended first year painting class at CN Fine Arts College, he taught me history of art. I shall never forget the day he taught me portrait painting. During his 28 years career, Natu Parikh taught hundreds of youngsters. He was an example of an informed, dedicated teacher, a blessing to students and asset to the art world. This frail looking man could make sense of Vinci, Van Gogh and Cezanne. He noticed things that had nothing to do with classwork but were vital to a youngster's development. Nagji, never fret about what you don't have. Just make the most of what you do have, a skill. No one in my family had any art background, so there was no tradition of commitment to learning for me. I needed the push and stimulation of a teacher who truly cared. Natu Parikh gave plenty of both as he immersed me in a wonderful world of colors, strokes, and even compositions. He led me to believe that I could draw portraits to put renowned artists to shame.
છેલ્લા 30 વર્ષ એમની સાથે મારું કામ કરવાનો સંબંધ છેલ્લા 22 વર્ષથી કન્ટિન્યુ ચાલુ છે. એમની ખાસ એક તો બહુ જ સરસ વિશેષતા એ છે કે એ એટલા સહજ રીતે બધાની સાથે કામ કરે છે. મેં ઘણા અમુક આર્ટિસ્ટોને જોયા છે કે જ્યારે કામ કરતા હોય ત્યારે આપણે એમની સાથે જઈએ ને કે એમની પાસે બેસીએ એટલે કદાચ એમનું કામ કરવાનું બંધ કરી દે કે આવું એવા કંઈક અનુભવ પણ બંધ થયેલા. નટુભાઈ સાથે જીવનમાં ક્યારેય આજ સુધી અમારે એવું બન્યું નથી. ઇવન કોલેજમાં પણ જ્યારે અમને ભણાવતા હોય ત્યારે પણ ક્યારેય એવું બન્યું નથી. સહજતાથી એમની રીતે બધું શીખવી દે.
His former students knew the measure of a great teacher, love and motivation. His wisdom and influence had rippled out across generations. Born in Bandhani, a small village in Kheda district of Gujarat, Natu Bhai from an early age wanted only to be a painter. Painting did more than something to do. It awoke in me unsuspected capacities for pleasure. I began to closely observe everything around me, from the delicate coloring of a sunset to the soaring flight of a bird, and was filled with a profound sense of the beauty of nature. "What do you do with all your money?" a friend once asked him. Pointing at the studio, Natu Parikh said, "I fertilize this studio with it." It is true that he plowed money back into the studio almost as fast as it came in. Natu Parikh enjoys good health, except a knee problem, but it has not stopped him from going to locations for landscape painting, nor could he be prevented from painting every day for minimum 3 hours. If you want biographical details on Natu Bhai Parikh, there are few books around that trace his career from the early days in Bandhani, Pitch and Vadodara to his place in the pantheon of favorite art teachers. Natu Bhai, whose name finds a place in the All India Art Directory, was born on January 14, 1931, inheriting his father Chetalal Bhai's love for art. His two other brothers too have taken to art. Father wanted him to become a pleader, but Natu Bhai was already deep into painting, a passion that was to become his profession later.
My birthplace is Bandhani, a small village, but a nice village. And anybody can never forget his native place. So when I remember my native place, I feel that it was a village where greenery was ample around the village. And we had a fine pond. There every evening I was going. And especially in the evening time, sunset, I was enjoying. And the landscape there, I mean, was also fine. Bubble trees were ample and neem trees. So landscape just entered in my mind from my birthplace. And I have painted many landscapes of bubble trees. One day, you see, I had just been out to get a landscape. I wandered from morning till 12, but I didn't get no spot from anywhere. Suddenly, I saw two trees, bubble trees. And at 12, I made a landscape of that bubble tree, just a fine panel. And that was purchased by Jahangir Kama.
Impression of his childhood spent in village, that of rivers, hill, the green woods, were so deep in his mind that he could not draw and paint anything else than nature in abundance. The play of soft colors like colors being burst by sunrise is a play of him. Rivers and seascapes are enchantingly fine in his work. His sky is play of Turner, who is his favorite artist, and his sea is a roaring sea.
I feel that from 7 years of age, I might have started, you see. My father was interested in painting, and Dada was always telling, that is his photograph, that you see, let the boy do whatever he feels, allow him. So my father was bringing colors from Ahmedabad, Kitamiya, Gulam Ali. And from that day, I have used the colors of Winsor and Newton, everything of top quality. And today I believe that for young children to teach, nothing to be taught, if they are provided with the good material, they may go on working and get a good result. Because material inspires the artist. When I see colors, I am just a young man.
Though Natu Bhai took his BA in Gujarati literature, his interest in painting took him to Vadodara, where painters like N.S. Bendre live.
My brother once told me, what are you doing, brother? You are doing the traditional things. After that, so many things have been researched, and now people are doing something new and new that we call modern. You see, you come and see. I saw and I felt that I must leave this shop and I must go there. What experiments and what work. In my life, first time I saw every person differs from each other. And every painting differs from each other. With 300 rupees or 400 rupees I had, I left the job, sent the wife to her native place, one son here, one daughter there. That way, I started my career again. And there, you see, I got very good teachers, Bendre and V.R. Ambedkar, a very good critic. And I got, you see, lot of knowledge, I see. what one should do. The subject is not much more important, but the treatment, the way, and new approach that I got from Baroda.
Natu Bhai became an art master, then did his MA in art criticism in 1962. Then he came to CN Kala Mahavidyalaya, his alma mater, as a teacher in history in 1964 and worked there till he retired in 1991.
I came over here and 28 years have been passed serving here. During 28 years, I taught the student the history and portrait. For history, I was trained at Ambedkar. So, while I was teaching to the ATD students and painting students, just as if they are seeing the film, here I took the maximum benefit of the library. Every day, I had decided and just seeing one or two books. Here I started English classes also. And by seeing my work, I was appointed as the head of the department here. You see, I was working under the Siklal Parikh. So it was not matter that I was teaching because I am paid off. But I was teaching to get more and more love from the student.
Natu Bhai Parikh is well-known artist of Gujarat. He served 28 years in this CN Institute. He likes to render nature in its original form. Probably he is inspired landscape painting from his guru, Professor NS Bendre. He brings modern movement in his teaching because he went to Baroda. So whatever the abstract movement he learned there, and he brings this thing in Gujarat at that time. He is a very good portrait artist, and he wrote many books on art criticism, and also he wrote many articles on art criticism, and he served as an art critic in many newspapers in Ahmedabad. And he has tremendous love for students. Even though he is retired, he encourages students. And late, his development in abstract painting is abstract. He tends to become more abstract in his work. And I think he still remains young.
When he laughs so heartily that the soft features of his 76-year-old face show furrows. But he's not just another old man enjoying his autumn days. Professionally, Natu Bhai, retired art and history teacher, has been a portrait artist of note for long and is busier than a bee. But these days, his magnificent obsession for colors finds a fascinating expression in landscape painting at Shilaj village near Ahmedabad. May not only in vivid colors, but also with a vibrancy that seemed to lend a strange power to his landscapes.
In painting also, to two branches, going out, I would never like to be in the house for a month. After 50 days or a month, I may go out for outing. I like mountain, I like sea, I like trees. So I may go to the mountain or a riverside or a somewhere.
Mastering it with the tool of painting, Natu Bhai transforms the beauty on the paper without touching it. His paintings are transparent, yet true and faithful to its origin. Natu Bhai worships this beauty of nature. By painting it, he tries to create a harmony with it.
In the morning, I sit on the chair and paint daily from 8:30 to 11:30. And I don't feel pain, I don't feel anything, just going on.
Natu Bhai Parikh displays his command over the brush strokes and with the wash technique brings in a transparency. As I said earlier, even the wind is felt in some of his works. The artist also paints scenes of town that gives a character to the entire series. The people and their lifestyle certainly differ from the usual. In many street scenes, the play of light on tall buildings forms a cheerful atmosphere. Parikh also brings out characteristics of houses by showing wooden brackets, windows and roof tiles. Pure landscape painting by Natu Parikh is a welcome change for an average viewer who goes on seeing abstract, semi-abstract, cubistic work and so-called modern or creative work. Here, people can identify with sea, ships, street house and countryside. The mixture of water, sky and land is remarkable, which the artist distinguishes as if making one aware of such limits. The human figures as tiny as nail prints. They are part of the landscape, but remain small and surrendered. Sky is prominent in Natu Bhai's works, and to this he explains that he loves the form of the clouds. Changing it at every other moment, these ethereal objects of the sky are beautiful. Their fluffiness under the white-grey balls shows uncertainty and assures of the moments of downpour. For this particular love of the artist, he says that he has built his Haroka especially at his home in the city.
My birthday is 14th January. Luckily it happened so. But it's a day of joy. It's a day of kite flying, which I like also. In young days, I was just flying also. So that day is a colorful day. Sky is full of colors. And my love with colors is just refreshing every 14th January. And you will wonder that every 14th January, I put a new canvas on my stand, on my easel, and I paint a new painting.
All artists do not achieve instant fame, but they definitely create pieces which serve as milestones in their quest for perfection. Landscape drawings by Natu Parikh amply prove the fact, writes Jyoti Bhatt. People who come in contact with Natu Bhai would always love him because they see in him an absolutely ordinary man who had become very famous and well-known, yet never left his real self behind. Make no mistake though, Natu Bhai is serious about those things he believed important in life. Family, gardening, talent and warmth to all near and dear ones. That is Natu Bhai all the way and natural.
I have seen him floating in the penumbra of colors and wrapped in the soft sheets of rainbow hues. I have witnessed his blossoming changing shades in the chiaroscuro of life. I have seen swells of ultramarine and burnt sienna in his brushstroke. I have seen sheer love dripping in his depiction of trees, streets, villages and fairs. In this slippery world, I have seen him balancing his household on rough fingertips. On the sea of vast canvas, I have seen visuals emerging and I have known him going amidst the emptiness surrounding him.
Nature in its various modes reveal different stories and the mystery of life. The calm water of the sea is hardly understood for its character. The height of a mountain is hardly fathomed. These are only appreciated. But when a painter paints this water and sea, he worships the beauty of nature more than trying to touch its water. When the watery cloud bursts into a downpour, the artist too pours his adoration for this particular happening on the paper. Here, he does not mean to copy it, but it simply shows an attempt of the artist who appreciates it. Natu Bhai is a mature artist who has many followers. He creates a harmony among colors. By uniting different colors, he creates uniformity.
While reading, I found that in India, we have Avin Babu, Nan Babu, and to my mind, Bendre and Rasik Bhai. These were Indian masters, which are my models. And really, I got from that. But after that, I saw Western masters, many. And especially modernist, from impressionist onward. So they had much of thinking, what else. And I realized that I should not paint those traditional things nowadays. I must give something new. I am using my guru's idiom or this or that. But after that, after going to Baroda, I thought, Baroda means 40 years back story. But I was talking about new things. But really I did new things after 70. I think rare persons will find that who might have thought something new after 70. My colors change, my subject change, my approach change, and my brother and my friends tell that these are your original pieces. Now you are original. Do that. Especially Banu Bhai and other friends told me by seeing the exhibition, Natu Bhai, don't leave this idiom. There I can remember my Guru Vendre. He told me that, you see, don't be so naturalistic. You see, sky can be red, sky can be blue, sky can be black even. When you paint, it is a painting. It is your thought. It is your decision. You go with the colors and color scheme, not with the original thing. Art is not nature. Nature is nature. Art is a transformation, a change through your mind coming out a art piece. At Baroda, I felt the departure from that tradition of illustrating the things. Illustration is illustration. It is a subject. It gives the running commentary. But painting is a painting by paint itself and technique of painting. When I go outing for study, nature, there I do realistic. That I have not left. When I do portrait, I do realistic portrait. But in painting, in my studio, I do modern works which goes more with colors. As said by Cezanne, painting is an architecture of tones and colors. Painting is an architecture of tones and colors. The subject is not needed. You can paint one subject in a several ways. Subject is not important. So I go that way. The other artists like Whistler, the Mondrian. You see, I have many paintings on Mondrian. Space division. Space division, nature space differ. Space division of canvas differs. Canvas 2x2x2, 4x4, that to be divided in many ways. So now I divide the space, even in painting river in a new way. That is the division of space of the canvas.
Right from 1972, he has been holding one-man shows of his works in Mumbai and Gujarat. His paintings have found place in many art collections in the country and abroad.
In one of the exhibitions, I was introduced to Natu Bhai, and then subsequently when his exhibitions came, I also wrote about his exhibitions. He's a few remaining classical landscape artists. Very few teachers are successful as a artist, because they remain busy with their classes and their personal work is very, very rare and few. But in case of Natu Bhai, he has given after his retirement, within a short period of time, he has given number of good masterpieces.
I thought they have a quality of permanence, which many modern abstract paintings do not have. You get bored and tired. I am not tired of this painting, which is a good test of it. Now, they combine realism and abstract impressions, and is capable of using his brush in many different genres, expressions, I would say. For instance, this one, trees, brown background, everything. But in the background, you get the leaves, etc. And the color, you see the sense of background, as it is noticeable here. Sky has realistic touch. Evening sky, you can see. But the boats, etc., are impressive. The sea, distant, is also there. So everything combines very well. It's a balanced composition. My own preference is not for portraits. So I buy things which appeal to me most, that is landscape, and those two flower paintings, which I thought will fit in there on that wall.
Natu Bhai is a compulsive painter and cannot resist picking up the brush once the scene charges him up.
I have painted Gandhi, Sardar, Tagore, not once, several times. And once upon a time, I can say that I was called as artist of Gandhi. I have painted several Gandhiji, and then got a project, and I worked with him. I was painting without reference Gandhi of several age, 13, 14, 15. That much command was on the structure of Gandhi. This painting, when I did, I thought of grandness of Gandhi, and therefore I put sea in the background and sky. The sky is taken from the landscape. It is quite grand and colorful. You see, you can see miles. Miles and miles in that range, Gandhi looks grand.
He has number of publications at his credit, namely Kala Sanskar, Kala Surjan and Kala Vrut.
Mostly I have written on art an artist. I interviewed the artist. If I see some talent in somebody, I just say, I will write about it. It is not that he is my friend, so I write. Then I have visited Indian temples and sculptures. That when I saw first time in Ajanta, I realized what is an art. And art comes because of that understanding. It may be modern or realistic, or it may be traditional or whatever it is. But when it is a true piece of art, it remains within. And in my article, especially appreciation of art pieces, sculptures and painting. Whenever I talk, I never envy the artist and speak less like so many others. I admire them and put forward.
As an artist, he is spontaneous. He would move out and he draws nature. Well, when I was taking up my MA, I was doing a job also in a school simultaneously. It was 1964. I was teaching English and Natubhai was teaching drawing. So it is more than 40 years since we are friends. Our friendship has been cemented through our common interest. He is also a writer. He is also a very good teacher. He is also a very good speaker and a conversationalist also. His community gatherings would be dull, drab, dreary without his presence. As a friend, he is quite unique. He could go to any length. Natubhai has done a lot for his family. He took care of his mother until she breathed her last. She was a little mentally derailed, and so caused sometimes troubles and embarrassments in the family. But he bore it silently without saying a harsh word to the mother. He also saw to it that his two brothers get proper education. Jayanbhai Parikh and Manu Parikh are renowned artists in their own rights. Whatever they are today, they owe a lot to their elder brother.
I think in our family, my father, my great grandfather, who was an ordinary grocer in the village Bandra, right? He did one mistake, or he did a good thing, that he has given admission here in CN Kala Vidyalaya before 55 years before. That was a great incident in our life, right? If Natubhai is not from over here, then our family have a different sort of culture development. And after that, we were benefited because as a elder brother, he says now Jayan should go in the finals, right? So I was very grateful. I was very grateful to him because he suggested my father that he should. I was an ordinary boy, Gadheda no ghar jato. I was very ordinary. So he was always thinking how Jayan will develop. And after that, I developed, right? So that was a great thing that Manu has taken admission in fine arts, and that's why we got a platform for the art and culture also. Otherwise today I might have in Anand in Gan Bazar having a grocer in the same manner. When we meet Natubhai, that time we don't discuss the social problems. He talks regarding Van Gogh, Rembrandt, sometimes Indian painter. I also oppose regarding rhythm, dance, music. So that sort of thing we discuss with Natu, because he's a learned person.
Natubhai was a loving husband to Shardaben. Alas, she is no more with us.
Today I remember her that way. She's not now, but she has supported me a lot, because I had not to think of house. I have not to care for house. I have not to care for children. I had merely to paint and serve. She was careful for my painting. This is one thing at home. But you will wonder that when we were going in outing in the forest of Dan, she was a fearless lady. She was sitting by my side. I was always worried that the animal may come this way. So she was just helping in every way. Basically, I'm a portrait artist. So for experimenting in portraiture, I was requiring model always. When I was feeling that I may experiment of this color, this technique, this style, I was telling, just sit as a model. So I can say that she was my wife, but a model also. And I have ample portraits of her.
Natu Bhai is a caring father. He is also a very affectionate friend. With his cheerful disposition, he brings joy and happiness wherever he goes.
Lives of great men all remind us we can make our lives sublime. In departing, leave behind us footprints in the sands of time.